Hi all, I'm Ankur Gupta. Hope all of you are doing well. Welcome to Analytics School. Today we will discuss about Proc Tabulate. Proc Tabulate is another SAS processor in SAS to quickly display descriptive statistics for one or more variables in a tabular format. The main advantage of using Proc Tabulate is mainly used to create a professional looking report. Now let's do some examples and see the features of Proc Tabulate. Let's run the proc print command and let's see how our data looks like. You can see here, there are seven variables: region, product, subsidiary, which are categorical variables. Stores, sales, inventory, and returns are numerical variables. Let's verify that by using proc contents procedure. There are 395 observations, seven variables. And you can see the data type of the variables. Inventory is numerical, product is character, region is character, returns is numerical, sales is numerical, stores is numerical, and subsidiary is character. Now let's do a basic example of Proc Tabulate, understand its syntax and its terminologies. We can call the Proc Tabulate procedure by Proc Tabulate, and we are going to call the SAS Help library and going to use a shoes dataset. The first statement is var statement, where I am going to call the numerical variable. Class statement, here I am going to call the categorical variable. There is another statement here, which is table, and I am going to call region, comma sales, run. The var statement tells us that these variables are targeted variables for analysis. It should be numerical variable, and it is used to create summary statistics for us. The class statement tells us that these are the categorical variables, whereas table statement tells us which variables are related to row and which are column variables. Now, the table statement, if there are no commas in the table statement, SAS assumes you are only defining the column expression. What does that mean? So let's say if we comment out class statement and remove region from here. This means that there are no commas in the table statement, and SAS assumes you are only defining the column expressions. Basically, region was row there at that point of time. So here, when we use the categorical variables, region was a row or index, and sales is going to be my column variable. So let me comment it out and let's do a very basic example first. And I have removed region from here. If we are going to run this code, by default, it is not going to give any statistical measure. This is the default feature of Proc Tabulate. It calculates some of the numerical variable that we want to analyze, that this is the total sales for shoes dataset. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to call region in class statement, and I'm going to put here region and comma. So region's attribute will be my index and sales will be my column. And you see here, we got the sales by different regions in shoes dataset. Now let's say you want to transpose the dataset, meaning you want to have region on the columns and sales value as index. Just change the position from sales to region and you are done. You can see here, this is how our data looks like. I had mentioned in the beginning of the session that Proc Tabulate helps us to conduct the descriptive analytics for one or more variable in the dataset. But by default, it does not provide us the custom statistical measures. It just provides a total of the variable which we are trying to analyze for the whole dataset. So how we could add custom statistical measure in our dataset? Let's say we want to have count, min, max, range, Q1, Q3, mean, median, etc. How we can add these custom statistical measures in Proc Tabulate? Let's see that. Proc Tabulate data equal to SAS help dot shoes variable sales class region table sales. Let me put up here region as a row, sales. Now I'm going to put up an asterisk sign and going to call the custom statistical measures. Range, mean, median, standard deviation. Let's run the code and see the output. You can see here, we have got a statistical analysis for each and every region by passing my statistical measure in brackets and an asterisk sign. So that is the only thing which you need to do. Now let's say, and it is not compulsory, you need to have your target variable and then you have to put up an extra sign. If I change it to sales here and region, it is just going to transpose how our data looks like. And that is the beauty of Proc Tabulate. And you can see here, it's just the same result, but transposed. So it doesn't matter whether you are having a categorical variable which you want to group or the sales. It is just about where you want to have rows and where and what variable you want to have as a column. And this is how one can get custom statistical measure using Proc Tabulate. Now let's do another example where we are going to have the grand total, as well as we are also going to rename the variable names as well as the matrix as per a requirement. Let's see that how we can do that in Proc Tabulate. Proc Tabulate data equal to SAS help dot shows var sales class region. The whole magic happens here in table statement. What I'm going to do here, region, I'm not going to call it anything. Then I'm going to call all. And I'm going to say as grand total. For my column, I'm going to call sales and I'll mention it here as regional sales. And then I'm going to put up an asterisk sign and going to call my custom matrix. N is equal to total count. Min equal to min sales, max equal to max sales. And you can see here it's pretty intuitive. You do not have to worry about anything. Average sales run. One more thing, in the box, in this particular box, I want to put up a region there. Box equal to region. Let me run the code. So you can see here is region and my column name has changed to regional sales. Moreover, N has become total count, min sales, what has been the minimum sales of Africa region, what has been the maximum sales, and what has been the average sales for Africa region. Similarly for Asia, 14, 937, 149 and 13, 32,873 is an average sales. So this is how you can customize the column names, as well as you can also add some more features into your data set. One thing which I forgot to mention, you see here is a grand total. So these are the 395 records. The minimum sales, if you will see here, the minimum sales is 325. So it is giving you 325. Maximum sales is 1,298,717. You can see it is in Middle East. And this was an average number, 85,717. So this is how we can build up custom report. Let's do one last example where we are going to call product, region, and subsidiary. And on the basis of these categorical variables, we are going to analyze the sales for shoes dataset. Proc tablet data equal to SAS help dot shoes var sales class region product subsidiary. Now the magic statement of proc tablet table, I am saying region equal to nothing into, here I'm creating an interaction feature between region and subsidiary nothing, then I'm calling all equal to, let's say, final. Then this is my index or row, that how my index should or the row expression should look like. Now I'm calling product into sales, which I'm saying as subsidiary sales. N equal to total count, or let me copy and paste this thing, and I'm calling region and subsidiary, and let me run the code. I did not put up an asterisk sign. That is why we got an error. And now you can see this is a pretty comprehensive report. Maybe it is not making sense because it has only one record for everything. But let's say if you are working on a data set and you want to build up a report something like this, Proc Tablet gives you all the ammunition to build up a custom report as you want. And that is the most important feature of Proc Tablet, which you might not get with proc means, and let's say if you can get it, you have to write lot of code. By this example, we come to an end of this session. In the next example, we will see how we can calculate confidence interval using SAS. Till then guys, take care, have a good day.